Bless you. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. It is well. It is well. Hallelujah. Yes, God, my Father, I'm coming to pray this prayer. Yes, we want to pray. We want to pray to stop this power that is oppressing people, that is tormenting people, that is discouraging people. People are being tormented. These enemies, they don't want you to sing your song, to dance your dance. They don't want you to be happy. They want to oppress you. Some people right now, they feel the fear. This fear really attacking you so hard, especially this time of the holiday. You don't know what to do. So I'm coming up. The Holy Spirit told me to come up with this prayer so that people can be set free. I didn't pray. I didn't plan to come for this prayer. I had no ideas. The Holy Spirit told me, go, and do the prayers. Pray for people, because some people right now, they are going through trauma. They fear, even they don't want to go out, even work. Some of you are fired from work because you don't feel like going to work. You don't feel like doing anything. You just want to stay in the house. And in the house you are paying. It is not a free house. That is the demon. That is the enemy. Let the enemy be scattered. That is the enemy. That's the one to destroy your life. That is the enemy want to disgrace you. That is the enemy want to fight you. Right now, some people, they are going through a difficult time. They fear. Even your car, you can't drive. You want to stay in the house. You fear, you are shaking. That is the demon. The demon are raising up to bring destruction. Now they want you not to go to work. Now you can be fired. Some of you have already been fired because of what you are going through. Some, they fear everything, even the weather. You fear. There's a demon of fear that has been sent to attack people, to torment you. You can't even sleep. You fear completely. I pray, oh wind of God, drive away every power of that ungodly arising against you, against your health, arising against your life. Let them be destroyed. Let them be rendered powerless. Let the rage of the wicked against you be rendered imported in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will deliver you. God will set you free in the mighty name of Jesus. Enemy that is attacking you, right now, I come against them. I command them to be destroyed in Jesus' name. The Bible says in the book of Psalm 68, verse 1, let God arise and let his enemy be scattered. Let them also that hate him flee before him. Let God arise and let his enemy be scattered. Let enemy that is oppressing you be scattered. Let enemy that is tormenting you be scattered. Let enemy that is discouraging you to be scattered. Let enemy that is frustrating you be scattered. The Bible says that enemy that is frustrating you, that enemy that is making you to feel sick, that is an enemy. Let them be scattered. Let them be scattered. Let them be scattered. In the name of Jesus, let the imagination of the wicked against you, against your life, be neutralized and be scattered in the name of Jesus. The Bible says the enemy will be scattered in the name of Jesus. The Bible says the enemy will be scattered. Let the enemy be scattered in the name of Jesus. Every counsel of evil kings against you be scattered. Every evil counselors, every evil gathered, those sickness that has been gathered together to frustrate you, to punish you, let them be scattered, let them be scattered, let them be rendered powerless in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that God will arise and speak great wrath against the enemy of your breakthrough, the enemy that is fighting you right now. Let God arise and destroy them in the name of Jesus. Every band of the wicked that is arresting your program, your progress, break in Jesus' name. I pray the blood of Jesus. I pray that God Almighty will set you free from the powers of oppression, from the powers of frustration, from the powers of being tormented. The demon of fear that is attacking you right now, let it be scattered. This is a deliverance and healing ministry. People have been tormented. People have been tortured. You have no idea what you are going through. But I'm coming to you and to talk to you, to pray with you right now. I am speaking to that enemy that is attacking you, giving you discouragement. You feel so discouraged from no reason. You feel depressed. You are not happy. You are not happy because everything is not going well with you. The holiday is coming, especially this day they call Christmas. You have nothing. You don't know what to do. and the shopping, even the shopping itself, you are stressed and being depressed. You don't have the money to buy gifts. You don't have to worry about the gifts. You don't have to kill yourself, be sick and being worried, be crying because you don't have money to buy the gift. You are a child of God. And I pray that God will take away that fear of spirit of holiday, spirit of Christmas that is tormenting you. Let it be scattered. Let it be scattered. Let it be scattered. Every cord of darkness meditating against you, against your breakthrough, let it be scattered. Let it be rendered powerless. Oh, let it be rendered powerless. Let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. You know, there is powers that make you that you cannot achieve anything. When you are about to get something, it comes and it stops you. So they stop your breakthrough all the time. Let them be destroyed. Let them be rendered powerless in the name of Jesus. Let God arise and speak unto your enemies. Unto your enemies and let them scatter. That is what the Bible says. They will scatter. They will render powerless. They will go where it came from. You will be free and you will be happy in Jesus' name. You are not alone. Remember, you are not alone. You are not alone. Don't worry about yourself so much. But it is a spirit, it is a demon attacking you so hard. Remember that you are shaken. You don't want to go, even to wake up from your bed. Yes. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Oh God, arise and speak unto the enemy. I am praying that let God speak to the enemy that is tormenting you right now to be destroyed and be bounded and be rendered powerless in the name of Jesus. Let God dust the power of stubborn pursues you in pieces. Let God dust them to pieces in Jesus' name. I pray that God will arise with all the weapon. Let God arise with his weapon and smash and cut them and cut that demon that is tormenting you. The demon that is tormenting you right now. Demon that is giving you heart blood pressure. Giving heart vibration. You don't, you have heart panicking. Heart vibration. Your heart is beating you so hard. Your head is full pressure. Your head, you have pressure. There's a lot of pressure in your head. Even you don't know what to do. I am cursing them. I bind them. I curse them right now. I bind that pressure in your head. I destroy them in Jesus' name. Depression spirit, I curse you. Schizophrenia spirit, I curse you. I command you to get out of the body, to get out of the person, to get out of that man, to get out and out in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, I am asking God to come against every that pressure in your head. Let God arise and destroy that pressure in your head. You are a pressure. You feel like your head is going to pass. That is the demon that has been programmed in your head to pressure you. In the mighty name of Jesus, I curse it. I bind it. I command them to die. In the mighty name of Jesus, you are back. You are back. You are joined. You feel so sharp backache. Even you can't sit, you can't stand, you can't sleep. You are feeling a lot of pain. Now, because of this pain, you feel so depressed. You feel uneasy. Let it die. Let it be destroyed right now in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray that God Almighty, let the glory lift your name. Let the glory of God fill you. Let the glory of God cover you. Let the love of God cover you. Let the love of Jesus cover you. You feel so rejected. You feel so unwanted. You don't like yourself. You hate yourself. Let that demon talking about you that I hate myself. You don't feel like you really hate yourself. That is a demon. Don't talk like that. Don't tell yourself like that. Love yourself because God is love and Jesus loves you. Don't hate yourself. That is a demon. You feel you will be okay. I'm praying for you. You will be recovered. Don't worry. That's why I'm coming here. I'm coming to you to talk to you that you are suffering. You are being feared, tormented in the name of Jesus. I cast them. God will hear your cry out God will hear your cry, and he's going to set you free. And God is going to set you free, and you will come out of that problem. You will come out of that pain. You will come out of that pressure. You will come out of that tormenting that you have been tormented all the time. Demon has been tormenting you. That you are being tortured. In the name of Jesus, I cast them out. I command them to get out in the name of Jesus. You will not be afraid of 10,000 of people that have set themselves against you in the name of Jesus. The Bible says you will not fear 10,000, and 1,000 will come from the other side. You don't have to fear them, because God will raise angels. Angels of God are more than 10,000 who are gathered against you. Remember, God has given you a divine protection. You are protected. You just fear negative. Negativity is the one which makes you to fear. There is nothing wrong, except that your mind has been programmed by demon. Now it is pressing you. It is vibrating you. It is scared you. Now you feel like everything is against you. That is a lie. 10,000 will come and gather together, but God will scatter them. They will be scattered in the name of Jesus. They will be scattered. God will smite your enemies by the cheekbone in Jesus' name. God will smite your enemies with the cheekbone. God will smite them, because God is a smiter. He will smite your enemies. Don't worry. Just pray God and trust him. Change your behaviors. Change your believers. Change that attitude. Change the spirit of fear. Say, God, smite my enemy. Smite the demon that is tormenting me now. Smite it. Smite it in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, God. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. God will resist every power lying against you with the destruction in the name of Jesus. You know, the devil is a liar. So anything lying against you, any spirit lying against you, the spirit of fear, the spirit of depressed, the spirit of frustration, the spirit of discouragement is a lie. They are lying. And God will come against them and bring destruction and destroy them in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, every pain you are going through, God is going to smite them. God is going to destroy them in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, thank you, Father. I know some of you, for sure, you are going through difficult time. Pain, even you feel like you want to give up. Don't give up. I don't know, this lady, she called me, she was in pain. She said she has tried it, it is serious. I told her, don't worry, God will help you. That pain will die in the name of Jesus. I cast out all your enemies in the magnitude of that transgression in the name of Jesus. I cast out every enemy. Enemy that is following you, enemy that is attacking you, follow enemies. I cast them out in the name of Jesus. I cast them out by fire. I cast them out by thunder. I cast them out right now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ, every organization worker of iniquity, I command them to depart from your life right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, anything the enemy is using against you to judge you, to pray against you, to attack you, to torment you, I am standing here as a servant of God to command them to be destroyed and rendered powerless in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, let all your enemy be ashamed and so vexed. Let all your enemy be ashamed and be vexed in the name of Jesus. You know, your enemy, they think that now they are putting you down. You will not be raised up because of the spirit of fear has been tormenting you. Now it thinks that you will not wake up. I am praying for you right now. Let the very enemy who has put fear on you be ashamed and be disgraced and be foxed in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Yes, let Satan's shame be the rod of your oppressors in the name of Jesus. Let the enemies be ashamed. Let certainly ashamed be the rod of your oppressors in the mighty name of Jesus. Every power planning to tear you down. Every power planning to tear you down. Planning to tear your soul down. Planning to tear you down. Every power, every evil, all of witchcraft, every wizard, any power from the occult kingdom that is planning to tear you down, Let the ground open and swallow them in Jesus' name. Let them be dismantled in Jesus' name. Every power planning to tear you to tear your soul down like a lion, be dismantled. Be dismantled, be dismantled, be dismantled, be dismantled in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, I want to thank you. I want to bless you. I want to give you the glory. I want to give you the honor. You are a great God, Father. I destroy every power planning to tear you down, every power planning to disgrace you, every power planning to bring sorrow on you. Let it be dismantled. Let them be dismantled. Let them be disgraced. Let them be rendered powerless in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. I command judgment on all your prayers in the mighty name of Jesus. I command judgment of God to all your oppressors, every oppressors. Let judgment of God fall upon them. Let judgment of God fall at them. Let the wicked of the wicked come to an end in the name of Jesus. Let the wicked of the wicked come to an end in the name of Jesus. Oh God, prepare an instrument of death against your enemies. Let God prepare an instrument of death against your enemies. When the enemy wants to kill you, to destroy you, let God himself prepare an instrument of death and fall upon them. You shall not die but live to declare the word of God in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, the sickness, the demon that is tormenting you, let it go back where it came from. Send it back to the sender. Send it back to the owner in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, yes. Let God ordain the arrow against your persecutors. Let God ordain the arrows against your persecutors. And these arrows, let them go straight to their heart and kill them. The thieves that are coming to steal from you. Sometimes you dream, you miss your pass, you miss your iPad, your phone. Those are poverty. When you dream that you miss something, especially your pass, especially your cell phone, especially your iPad, your TV, your whatever, that is the demon is coming to cut out your communication. Nobody will talk to you. They cut every link. Nobody will help you. And they want you to be poor. That is the demon of poverty. Therefore, I cast them. I bind them. I render them powerless. I render them to be destroyed by fire, by thunder. In the mighty name of Jesus, I destroy the demon of cobwebs. Demon of cobwebs. Demon of cobwebs. I command you to catch fire and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Yes, God. Thank you, Father. I pray right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command, let every pit dug by the enemy become a grave for the enemy. The enemy, they have dug the pit for you to enter. Let the very pit they have dug for you, let it be turned to their grave, and themselves, they will enter there, and they will bury them in Jesus' name. Because they dig a dig for you to enter in, but themselves, they are going to enter in. That's what the Bible says. They will enter in and be buried there in Jesus' name. Because they are planning wicked. They are now watching and see what is going to happen to you. And they are laughing at you. They are celebrating at you. They think that now you are feeling it. It is a spirit. If you see what they are tormenting. One time I saw somebody, a woman, was carrying a big rod. And there is another woman who was pressing the person down. Now the person was really crying. The person was crying, I feel my neck, my body. I saw the woman was pressed down with another woman with a big rod. Then I commanded that rod to go back to the owner. And then the owner started calling and feel it. That is how it is. Those, if your teeth is paining you, the enemy is bringing the hammer and they start to hammer your teeth. Even the gum, they inject it and they remove the injection. Now you feel a lot of pain. That, and they are loving. They torment you so much. Child of God, every demon that is tormenting you, let them die. Let them be destroyed. Let them be rendered powerless in the name of Jesus. Let the mischief of your enemies return upon their own head in Jesus' name. Let the mischief of your enemies return to their own head in the mighty name of Jesus. Let all weapon of your enemies backfire by thunder. Let all the weapon of your enemies backfire by thunder. Let them be backfire by thunder in the name of Jesus. Oh God, ordain strength for this person. So and they can steal that enemy in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, I pray, God Almighty, order the enemy to turn themselves and start killing themselves. Order the enemy turn against themselves and destroy themselves in Jesus' name. Yes, thank you, Jesus. When your enemies and turn back, they shall perish out of the presence of the Lord in Jesus' name. Yes, thank you, Jesus. Yes, God, you are good in the name of Jesus. Oh God, destroy the wicked and put out their names forever in the name of Jesus and never, never, never be remembered in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, God, we are praying, destroying the powers of the wicked, evil powers tormenting you, making you miserable. You have been suffering a lot. So I'm coming to destroy the demon that is attacking you, making you miserable. Fear, oppressed, that is oppressing you. Oppressors shall die. I cast them out of your life right now. You demon of oppressor, get out. Out from this person. Get out with all your roots. I'm cursing you by fire, by thunder. Discouragement, frustration, rejection. I curse you in Jesus' name. Witchcraft that is operating right now. People are so much oppressed. They are so much depressed. They feel like they want their head is passing. Let them be destroyed. Let the enemy be destroyed in Jesus' name. The Bible says they will scatter. They will scatter in Jesus' name. Ah, yes, Lord. Oh, God, destroy the wicked and put out their names forever and ever in the name of Jesus. Let the enemy sink in the pit they have made in Jesus' name. Let the enemy sink into the pit they have built. Let them sink. They think you are going to enter. If they are themselves, they will enter in and die in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Let the enemy sink in the pit they have made. They think they have dug a pit for you to enter. Let themselves to enter in and die in the name of Jesus. Let the feet of the enemy be taken in the net which hide in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, thank you, Father. I bless the blood of Jesus. I thank you. I give you all the glory. I'm praying for you right now because you have been oppressed. You have been frustrated. You have been rejected. You have been tormented. You have no idea what to do. This is a deliverance prayer that I'm praying. It is a prayer to set you free from being tortured and being tormented in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm praying that God will set you free right now by fire, by thunder, in the name of Jesus. Let the wicked be snared in the work in his own hands in the name of Jesus. Let the wicked be catched by is what he is planning against you. Let them cut themselves. The net they put you for you to cut you, let that net turn and cut themselves in Jesus' name. Oh God, arise. Let not man prevail. Let the heathen be charged in the name of Jesus. Yes, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Yes, let the wicked be taken into the devices they have imagined in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Oh, God, arise. Lift up the arm in the war in the name of Jesus. Break down arm of the wicked and the evil men in Jesus' name. Let God break the arm and the evil people in Jesus' name. Upon the wicked, oh God, rain snail, fire and brimstone, and terrible tempest in Jesus' name. Your enemies shall not rejoice over you in Jesus' name. Your enemies shall not rejoice over you in Jesus' name. They will come in one way and they will fly in seven ways. The Bible says in the book of Deuteronomy, they will come in one way and they will fly in seven ways. Your enemies will come in one way and they will fly in seven ways. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, yes. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes, my God. I thank you, Jesus. Your enemy shall not rejoice over you. They will not rejoice. Your enemies will not rejoice. They will cry. Now they are watching the way you are been going, what you are going through. Soon and very soon, you will be rejoicing, and them they will be crying. Everything they are doing to you, it is going back to them. What they are doing, the press, the frustration they are putting on you, it is going back to them, to their head, to their own head. In Jesus' name, I pray that God will arise and disappoint your oppressors and cast them down in the name of Jesus. God will arise and disappoint your oppressors and cast them down in the name of Jesus. God will deliver your soul from the pit of hell in Jesus' name. Yes, your enemy will get the biggest disappointment in the mighty name of Jesus. My God, I want to thank you, Jesus. I bless your name, God. I want to give you all the glory. Thank you, Heavenly Father. You are God. You are God. There is no one like you. Jesus, I want to thank you. Jesus, I want to bless you. Jesus, I give you the glory in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says in the book of Psalms 49, verse 25 to 26, but thus says the Lord, even the captivities of the mighty shall be taken away, and the blade of the terrible shall be delivered, for I will contend with him that contend with thee, and I will save the children, and I will feed them that oppress thee with their own flesh, and they shall be drunk with their own blood as with sweet wine, and all flesh shall know that I, the Lord, I am the Savior and the Redeemer, the Mighty One of Jacob. The Bible is clearly says that God himself is going to feed your oppressor with their own blood, with their own flesh, and they will feed them good. God is going to deal with those people who are oppressing you, wicked people, demons, witchcraft. This is what the Bible says. Look at your Bible. Isaiah 49, verse 25 to 26. This is what the Bible says. And I will feed them that oppress thee with their own flesh, and they shall be drink with their own blood, as with sweet wine, and all flesh shall know that I, the Lord, I am the Redeemer and the Savior, I'm the Redeemer, the Mighty One of Jacob. Lie. Oh yes, you are a good God. You are a mighty God. King of glory, I want to thank you. I want to bless your name because you are God who is going to feed my enemies with their own flesh, with their own flesh, with their own blood. You are not God who jokes. In the name of Jesus, my God, I thank you. Lord, I bless your name because you will feed my enemies. Every drink of blood and eaters of flesh coming against you, let it die. Drink us of flesh and drink us of blood shall not locate you. They will not drink you. They will drink their own blood. They will eat their own flesh. That is what the Bible says. Isaiah 59, verse 25 to 26. Look at that scripture. There is some people who are known of drinking and eating flesh of human being, but God is going to feed them. They are not going to drink you. They will drink and eat their own. That's what the Bible says. The Bible says, through an oath should encamp against you, your heart shall not fear in the name of Jesus. They will come together, but you shall not fear. You will be set free. They will come together. They will gang together. They will come together, but not against you. They will not come, but not against you in Jesus' name. Although war should rise against you, in this you will have confidence in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes. Yes, you will have confidence. God shall destroy the camp of your enemies, and their camp shall never be built up in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. God, I praise your name. You are good, God. Yes, my Father, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Your time is in the hand of God. Your time is in the hand of God. You are everything, your ways is in the hand of God. People of God, you have dedicated yourself to God. Everything is in the hand of God. You have put yourself to the hand. God will control you and God will help you. God is your Father. He loves you so much. Don't be distressed. Don't be depressed. Don't fear. He will take care of you. He said, I feed the animals who does not work. He feeds the birds of the air. He crushes the grass. So you don't have to, you are his child. You are the child of God. So God knows you. Don't fear. Don't live in that life. In Jesus' name. Let the wicked be ashamed and let them be silenced in the grave. Let the wicked be ashamed and be silenced in the grave. Let them die. Because this is the work of the wicked. It is the work of Satan. It is the work of evil men. In the mighty name of Jesus. Every lying lips speaking against you, be silenced in Jesus' name. Oh God, bring down counsel of the ungodly to naught. Every evil counselor, let God bring them down and destroy them in Jesus' name. Yes, many sorrows shall be to the wicked. In the name of Jesus, many sorrow will be to the wicked. Many sorrow will go to the wicked. Yes, many souls. The soul, it will go to the wicked. Wicked will suffer. 2017, wicked people, if they are not going to repent, the judgment of God will fall upon them and they are going to be destroyed. Every wicked people, God is going to deal with them. Yes, God, my Father. I thank you, Jesus. You are a great God. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I love you. Lord, I worship you. Lord, I thank you, Jesus. Let not them that are your enemies wrongfully rejoice over you. They should not rejoice because they are going to suffer. God is going to inject them. God is going to banish them. Hallelujah. 2017 is a year of victory. It's a year of conquer your enemies. It is a year of overcomers. You will overcome every enemies. Those wicked, if they are not going to repent, they will be judgment of God will strike them and they will suffer. They will be exposed. Men are going to be exposed and be disgraced. All those wicked and false prophets, false teachers, false apostles, all of them, they are going to be disgraced and exposed in Jesus' name. The judgment of God will fall upon the wicked, no matter who they are, whether the priest and prime minister, queen, all them, they are, the judgment of God are going to fall upon them and destroy them in Jesus' name. Yes, thank you, thank you, thank you. Yes, 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 correct. Thank you, sweetheart. You are like good people. You are a very good student. I don't know where you've been. You need to follow me every time. Yeah, I love you. Thank you so much. I love you. Yes, you know. Yes, God, thank you. Yes, my God. Yes, yes, I know that. Thank you, thank you. We worship God every day. There's no day. We don't worship the day. That's why you have to be careful. Even the Christmas day, it is not the Christmas 25th. It's not the day Jesus was born. We know Jesus was not born on Christmas day. That is 25th is a whole day for Christians to celebrate and they have communion and talk to their people. But don't celebrate. Don't say that Jesus was born. You will be a liar. You will be a liar. So let us continue with our life. And let us fight the enemy. That is fighting us. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes, God, thank you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Every work of death be cast down and be unable to rest again in Jesus' name. Yes, thank you, Jesus. My God. Yeah. Yes, Jesus was born on X. No, Jesus was not born on X. No. That's lying doctrine and wrong. People are preaching about that the angel of God came on this day on 25th and Mary was bringing and gave birth. It is wrong. So we know, even pastors, even everybody knows that Jesus was not born on Christmas Day. So we have to celebrate the end of the year, our year, and celebrate that we thank Jesus that he was born and we have to thank him. We honor him. So we thank God. We thank God and we celebrate. We celebrate what he did. We have to give him glory. Yes. Yes. Nobody knows when Jesus was born. But the Bible is clearly saying that the sixth month is when Mary and the sister went to visit Mary went to visit the cousin called Elizabeth, and the baby jumped on the berry, and Elizabeth says, you are calling a holy person. Now we don't know from there. You can calculate if Mary was on pregnant the 6 months, so we can't tell, and we don't have to give wrong doctrine. Nobody knows about that. So wherever people are guessing, God is not against. What we know, Jesus was born, and we have to choose a day to celebrate and thank God for what that is in the world. We thank him. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. We don't have to fight about the day and death. Let us thank God because Jesus was born. If we will concentrate and fighting about the day and death, then we will be a liar. He didn't give us. He did. They hide it. So he knows. Why didn't other reports like this Eastern? You see, it is showing. Yeah, during the Pentecost, it's showing after 50 days. The Pentecost after Jesus left 50 days, the Holy Ghost came. They mentioned things which is not mentioned in the Bible. You just leave it to God. He knows why and why didn't it it's not mentioned. So we have to leave it to God himself. We deal with it. But we have to be happy and celebrate and dance and do everything to honor him. Yes? Yeah? You know, what we have to look into is our heart, salvation. If Jesus that you are celebrating is coming today, are you ready to go with him or you will go to hellfire? So the best thing at this time, if you are not giving your life to Jesus, give your life to Jesus. That's the best thing you can do to yourself. That's the celebration you can do. When you give your life to Jesus, the angels in heaven, they will celebrate. They will thank. They will be breakdancing in heaven. They will be very, very, very happy. So don't worry about the day and the death about Jesus when Jesus was born. What we know that he was born and we have to thank him. Hallelujah. Let's forget what we are doing. And let's go to attack this enemy that is attacking you. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. I want to bless your name. I give you all the glory, God. I destroy and bind out all the demon and works of wicked and evil doctrine of the enemy. Let it be cast and be destroyed in Jesus' name. Let them be desolate. Those who are loving at you to the scroll. People are loving at you. Let it be destroyed in Jesus' name. Yes. We are praying. I'm not taking question. I'm not going to answer any question. We are praying that let God arise and let his enemy be scattered. We are praying from the spirit of destruction, the spirit of fear, the spirit of tormenting you, the spirit that is frustrating people. If you are free from the spirit of tormenting, spirit of frustration, spirit of rejection, that's fine. Keep praying. Let us pray for those who have been attacked in the name of Jesus. Every enemy saying, where is your God? Be disgraced. Enemy that is saying, where is your God? Enemy that is disrespecting your God. Let them be disgraced and let them be powerless in Jesus' name. Yes, we thank God. God is good, God. I want to stop here. We pray that God will help you. Thank you for the book of Deuteronomy 15-68. You are correct. There is curses that has been raised against the enemy, against disobedient. The Bible then says these curses will fall upon those who does not follow the word of God. The curses will come and overtake them and destroy them. So we pray that any curse from God that will fall upon you, let God have mercy and forgive you. Cry to God and ask God to forgive you. Cry to God and ask God to have mercy upon you. Because this is the one God can handle. No human being. If God has raised the curse, he himself will forgive you and take the curse away. The curses that we are praying about is the curse that witch or anyone that has cursed you has put on you. That one will break it. But the one for God, we will request God, and God is God of mercy and full of compassion. He loves you. He will take it away, and he will wash you, and you will become like clean and white like snow. Even if your sins are like the blood, God himself will wash you and forgive you, and you will become as white as snow. The Bible says in the book of Isaiah 1 verse 18, so therefore, I pray that God will help you in Jesus' name, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you very much. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi, saying bye-bye to you. See you 9 p.m. We will be on. 9 p.m. I will be on. I'm going to speak about judgment of God will fall upon the wicked. Wicked judgment of God is going to fall upon the wicked. Come and join us. You can come and join us on prayer line. You can join us prayer line, Periscope, and God will help you. Join us. Periscope will be on. Prayer line will be on. Popcorn will be on. Thank you very much. See you 9 p.m. will be on again. In the morning, I was not talking. I had my throat was locked. I had a cold, but God has healed me. I'm okay. If you can see my video this morning, I was not able to talk properly. But now I'm okay. I'm fine. Thank you very much. God bless you. I love you so much, and there's nothing I can do about it. You know I love you. Remember to donate. Remember to send me a gift. As a gift, as your pastor, as your prophet, as your prophetess, I love you so much, and I need you, and I care about you. I am praying for you. You call me anytime you need prayers. I am here to help you in the name of Jesus. My number is 905-792-3798. Call me. I will pray with you, and I will stand with you. Our number is 905-792-3798. Also, you can reach us. Our number is another number is 647-608-5207. Thank you very much. God bless you. Remember to donate. Go to our website www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca and donate. If you have a PayPal account, go and donate through email through overcomersdhm@gmail.com. Just go to your PayPal account, write our email address, and then you will donate an amount you want to donate. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. In the next few hours, like 2 to 3 hours, I don't know what is the time right now, you will see me. 9 p.m. Central Time. I will be on in the name of Jesus. Yes, this is 5:20. I will be on. I'm coming 9 p.m. on Periscope, Prayer Line, and also on Popcorn. So I will be praying with you more prayers. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. Bye. Bye. I love you so much. There's nothing I can do about it. Yes, thank you, sweetheart. Bye.